use deductive reasoning and the distributive property to justify x plus y squared is equal to x squared plus 2xy plus y squared. Provide the reasoning for each step. Now, when they say use deductive reasoning and all of this stuff, it might seem like something daunting and new, but this is no different than what we've done in the past. In fact, we've done this very exact problem. So let's just do it step by step, show our logic, and that's essentially deductive reasoning. We're starting with a statement, and we're going to deduce that this is going to be equal to something else. So let's start with x plus y squared. Let's start with x plus y squared. X plus y squared. We know an exponent means to multiply something by itself that many times. So we know that this is the same thing, or we can deduce that it is the same thing as x plus y times, and I'll do this next x plus y in a different color, times x plus y. That's what x plus y squared is. Now, they say to use the distributive property. Now, just as a bit of review here, and we've seen it many, many, many times before. The distributive property just tells us that if we have a times b plus c, b, let me do as many colors as possible, b plus c, that this is equal to a, you distribute it, it's equal to a times each of these terms, a times b plus a times c, plus a times c. It's called the distributive property because you're distributing the a in all of the terms that in the expression that you're multiplying a by. Now, we can do the exact same thing here. Instead of an a, you can imagine this is an x plus y. And we can take this entire x plus y and we can distribute it onto both of the terms on this expression that it is multiplying. If this was an a, it would be ax plus ay. Now that it's an x plus y, we multiply the x plus y times each of those terms. And that's just by the distributive property. So by the distributive property, that's going to be equal to, distribute this onto each of them, x plus y times x, x plus y times x. And actually, I don't even have to write the x after it. I could just write it there. It doesn't matter whether you multiply x times x plus y or x plus y times x. Order doesn't matter. So that's that times that. And then it's going to be plus y times x plus y. Plus y times x plus y. And now we can apply the distributive property again. We have x being multiplied by x plus y, and then we have a y being multiplied by x plus y. So let's just do that again. So then we get, this is equal to x times x, plus x times y, plus x times y. I'm going through great pains to keep the colors consistent. Plus y times x, plus y times this x over here, plus y times that y over there. And I'm doing this a lot slower, and I'm not skipping any steps here. Now, what do each of these things equal? X times x, that is the same thing as x squared. So this is equal to x squared. This right here, xy, we have one xy, but then we have yx is also the same thing as xy. It doesn't matter what order you multiply it in. So xy plus xy is 2xy plus 2xy. And then this last term right here, y times y, that's the same thing as y squared. So we're done. We've used deductive reasoning. We've just used logical steps to start with a statement, to start with an expression, really. And we essentially just logically manipulated it. We started with, you can imagine, I guess you could call this a statement. I guess it's the best thing to call it. And we logically manipulated it to come up with another statement, another fact. We know that we know that this is equal to this using logical properties and distributive property and things like that, and properties of exponents.